Little engine go, bin 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 go. I'm losing control. Heroin and blow, Marilyn Monroe. Overdid the dose. Time to rip with pro. Up the in and go, like a wind window. Little engine go, little engine go.
Good luck, everybody else.
So if you miss a day to remember, I mean, I guess this is the band to do it for you. Good lord. I'm not missing out on the party this time. Code Orange, with their new album, Underneath. This is the fourth studio album by them, and holy hell, they're under the term hardcore punk, like I said, of what you would get of a Day to Remember, but it's weird because on some occasions he has he kind of sounds like Derek Whibley, the lead singer, where he also kind of sounds like Ollie Sykes, and he screams like Chester Bennington. It's very weird, but the vocal range is good, and it makes for some interesting tracks on this thing. The only one I found myself not really liking was Autumn and Carabine. It wasn't that bad. It's just, I don't know, I felt like for an album full of heavier stuff, this was kind of like the oddball there, and it was just kind of, not necessarily a turnoff, but it was one that kind of was like, okay, this is out of left field somewhat. Okay tracks, In Fear, Cold Metal Place, which is, Last Ones Left, and the title track, Underneath, and my favorite, Swallowing the Rabbit Hole. I mean, I didn't include the intro track on here. This was technically the first official track, but that one was just, like, you knew what you were in for. You and You Alone was great. Who Am I? The lead-off single that I had heard from this thing, Sulfur Surrounding, which has their more kind of punkier alt-rock aesthetic with a little bit of metalcore here and there. The Easy Way, Erasure Scan, Back Inside the Glass, and A Silver. I mean, if you just want pounding music, this is it. Like I said, A Day to Remember, that's the first band that pops in my head because they can do the pop punk very well, but then they can also flip it on you and do some sort of like metalcore breakdown or some alternative rock, and it just sounds darker and different from what we're used to hearing from anything in the mainstream. And, you know, these guys are, you know, they're from Pittsburgh, they're from my home state, so I was like, you know, I'll check them out just because I like to check out I like to call them the local bands because they're in the same state as me and whatnot, and I, you know, like to support them when I can. And I gotta say, glad I didn't miss out this time. I'm glad I decided to check this thing out because, golly, was this an enjoyable listen. Overall, a lot of upside. I'm happy with the way it turned out, and I think if I had to rate it, I would give it an 8.5 out of 10 for just pounding and just great music all the way around. Trust me, you will thank me later for telling you to check this out. I am, especially my favorite tracks. Go check the whole thing out, really. I mean, it's not like anything on there was super horrible. Even my least favorite track is tolerable on there, so you guys can tell me in the comments below, what did you think of this album? Did you like it? Did you hate it? And what were your favorite songs, least favorite songs from this project? And until then, I will catch you all in the next one.